Welcome to Mental Health Matters. This is Hwee Boon, and today I'd like to share 9 reasons why people go for therapy. By going for therapy, I'm talking about those that involves talk therapy, so where a person seeks a trained professional, a skilled helper, to help them with their issues in life or with issues that are painful or has them using dysfunctional behaviors to cope with life. So here are the 9 reasons why people go for therapy. First, they are persuaded by someone else to go for therapy, or that they are curious about therapy. This usually happens in community settings or where the service is free, like for example in school settings, or where the cost is quite low. Unless someone is very rich, I guess people don't really go to a paid private practitioner for therapy just for curiosity's sake. However, sometimes when the client comes in and says that he or she is here for therapy because of curiosity, usually there's a hidden issue that is beneath all this, and the person is trying to check out this therapist to see whether he or she is safe enough before divulging about all these problems. In the school setting, sometimes the children or the teenagers were introduced to having a therapist in the school or a counsellor in the school, and some of them who are more brave or curious or want to check things out, they will explore and look for the counsellor or the therapist. Others who are curious may decide to go with their friends, or they persuade their friends to go and see the counsellor, and the person can piggyback along and to see and find out what it is like to be in therapy or to be in counselling. So this is number one. People go for therapy because they were persuaded, or that it's out of curiosity. They are curious how it's like, and in this case, they are quite open to it. Reason number two, people go for therapy because they have some issues or they have some worries or troubles, but they had a good impression of therapy or counseling because of what they have gone through earlier on in life, or what they have witnessed or experienced via their family members or their friends. So they learn that it's okay to seek help, and that this person who's a counselor or a therapist might be able to help them with their problems. So when they have arising issues or they have worries or troubles, they can think about going to see a counsellor or a therapist for help. So this is the second group of people and the second reason why people seek help. A third reason people go for therapy or counselling is because it's safe. So in the therapy session or in the counselling session, everything is kept confidential unless you are going to self-harm or harm others, or that you had done something against the law, and that by law the counsellor is required to divulge. Otherwise, everything is kept safely and privately in the room. Most of the people out there have certain hidden sides to themselves which they do not want other people to know about. They want to appear to be strong and bright, cheery, happy. So they will usually repress all these aspects and not allow other people to know about it. Sometimes people do not even allow their best friends or their families or their spouses to know about such problems. But since the counselor or the therapist is someone who is a stranger and is trained, and by the ethical guidelines, the professional is supposed to keep everything confidential and private, it's safe for the person to go to, and that the person feels safe that nobody else in his or her life will know about what problems there are and nobody will get to hear of the details or the issues that he or she has. So this is the third reason why people go for therapy. A fourth reason people go for therapy is because while this person is willing to divulge or to talk about the issues or problems, there's no one there to listen to them. Perhaps all around this person are people who are very busy, or they are very preoccupied with their lives, or they have just too many things on their hands, and this person feels very isolated or left out, and that there's nobody else to hear him or her out. So when that happens, the person pays for someone to listen to the person out and to connect and to try and solve the problems that are out there that nobody else in the person's life seems to have time or to have the energy to bother with. So that's reason number four. Reason number five, the fifth reason why people will go for therapy is because perhaps around them, there's no safe person to listen. Maybe there are other people around the person has been quite critical or quite judgmental, or that the person lives in a very competitive world and has actually put on a facade that is different from what he or she is really like or feels like. Sometimes there's this imposter syndrome, and if you feel like an imposter, you have to struggle to just put on the front rather than the genuine side of you. So you can only expose this part to a person who is a stranger, who's able again to keep everything confidential, and that the person will not be part of your private lives or your circle, and nobody else will get to know about it. So this is the fifth reason, because there's no one else safe around to actually talk about such issues. So when a person feels safe enough to talk about his or her issues, and that if people listen to them and that they are safe enough to talk to, but they don't understand, or that they give you very trivializing or critical or very brushed off remarks, very dismissive remarks like, "No, you can just get over it, no, it's no big deal, no, why are you making such a big fuss out of it?" Then you might feel very trivialized. You might feel that people don't really understand your problems or what you are going through, and that you find it disappointing and you wish that someone else would know and understand. So this is when people also look for a therapist to try and understand how they feel, and in that sense they feel connected and supported and is able to find other solutions in the midst of this warm support. So this is reason number six, the sixth reason why people look for a therapist or go for therapy. A seventh reason why people go for therapy is when they are open to share their problems and they talk to people around them, and that they are safe and they are non-judgmental and they are there for them to support them, but they do not have any solutions to the problems that is faced. So this person runs out of solutions from himself or herself, as well as from all the people around. So this person seeks an expert to try and figure out some of the problems that are out there and to find some solutions. So this is another reason why people will go for therapy, because the therapist or the counsellor is a skilled helper. This is someone who's a trained professional who has learned about the etiology of the problems, how they come from, and how you should go about solving them. They help a lot of individuals with their problems, so they are considered to be very experienced and experts. And so a person seeks out them in order to find the solutions or to seek the advice of someone who's an expert and who's trained. The eighth reason why people look for a therapist or go for therapy is quite different from the rest. This reason is that if they don't actually go for therapy, they will suffer negative consequences maybe from a spouse, from a parent, from the family, from the boss, or from the school. So this is a person who's unwilling to go for counseling or therapy, but has to do it because otherwise the relationship will suffer. Sometimes this is for couples where the spouse is ready to give up on the marriage, and if the spouse doesn't go for therapy or counseling, then they will just go for a divorce immediately. Sometimes this is from the school or from the workplace, whereby you might be terminated or expelled if you do not actually go for therapy and change your behaviors. It can also be from the family. Sometimes an unwilling family member to join the family therapy for someone else, or that the person is the one who seems to have behavioral or attitude problems, and that the rest of the family wants this person to be treated. So this is the 8th reason why people go for therapy. The 9th reason why people go for therapy is quite sad. So this person who has exhausted all means and tried all the people around, etc., and everything has failed so far, and the person has become quite exhausted. So this is a last hope and a last chance before the person gives up on life. Usually when this kind of client goes to therapy, it's really quite worn out, maybe by all the stress and the criticisms or the rejection by the people and the world out there, feeling like a failure, feeling misunderstood and unloved, and just trying his or her luck to see whether a therapist is a final person who is able to give him or her some hope that he can be understood and he can be supported, cared for and loved. So this is the 9th reason why people go for therapy. So when I summarize and conclude all these 9 different reasons why people go for therapy, there are 2 main groups that surfaces. One group is a group that has been misunderstood, judged or criticized and rejected, and is trying to find someone trustworthy, warm, nurturing and present to listen to them, to support them and to see them. And these are the ones who are usually demoralized and feel rejected and maybe has a lot of shame and has felt a lot of humiliation and failure and just feels very isolated and lonely because nobody else seems to be out there to understand them or support them. So this is one group. A second group of people goes for therapy because the person has been feeling unhappy or unwell or injured, like emotionally injured, like maybe traumatized or something, and he or she wants to try and recover and go back to being healthy again, to being happy and well again. So the person seeks out an expert who seems to know what he or she is doing and to help him or her get back on the feet again. So this is a second group of people. Why do people seek out a therapist for help in the society nowadays, but they don't do that in the past? There are a couple of reasons. One is that maybe therapy was not so well known previously. It was only for the rich and it was quite exclusive. There were not so many skilled helpers around, like in Singapore, maybe about 20-30 years ago. The word counselling is probably not even in the dictionary or has not been heard by many people out there here. In comparison, nowadays, and the term counselling and therapy is quite widespread and most of the people know about it because there's the free service and there is the strong social support out there in Singapore. One other reason why people seek help and go for therapy nowadays instead of being those in the past It's because of the society nowadays, the modern society. Despite everything good about the modern society that we have nowadays, that comes with clean water, available food, transportation, education and opportunities for people around, and the internet, of course, you know, and being able to get access to news and a lot of resources quite freely. It also comes with a lot of stressors. I think the modern living is a lot more fast-paced than previous. So like previously, what happens is that maybe people don't work after sunset. You know, after sunset, what you do is that maybe you just rest and go to bed. And previously, when even though it could be, life could be quite hard and you could spend a lot of time working, it's generally jobs or work that requires a lot of physical labor. But nowadays it's changed to quite a lot of mental stimulation and a lot of work that requires your brain power, etc. And there are a lot more complex tasks that you do instead of the simple tasks that people used to do in the past. Apart from all this, there is also a lot of competition out there. There are a lot more people and a lot more people fighting for space, for job opportunities, for money. Previously, the same plot of land could be just occupied by maybe 100 people, but right now maybe you have 5,000 people living on the same plot of land. The close proximity with a lot of people can be very stressful. Going back to time, previously when you encountered a troubling event or situation, you can have more time to think about it. You might also have more time to spend in nature, and studies have shown that nature or being in the wilderness have a very healing effect on human beings. So right now with a fast-paced life, which is highly stressful and a lot of competition, you tend to spend more time on just trying to survive or earn money or to try to relax or to entertain yourself after work, well, because it's been so stressful, rather than going out to nature and just allowing yourself to be. There's a lot less time to be ourselves and a lot more time that you spend working and trying to do things or do things for people or to contact or connect with people. And you also have a lot less time to rest. I think these are the possible reasons why a lot more people nowadays need therapy as opposed to those in the past. Why would a person want to go for therapy just to talk to someone who's a trained helper, a skilled helper, and a therapist? One of the reasons is because by the training of a therapist or a counsellor, one is supposed to learn how to embody certain qualities that helps one to heal in therapy. Having said that, therapists and counsellors are human beings as well. So we are all different and we all embody different qualities. Usually a therapist brings along his or her character and personality into the role of a therapist. And by congruence and by genuineness, it means that the person is true to himself or herself and is displayed as such. So sometimes what happens is that a therapist or a counsellor has already such qualities from the start of being patient and open, being warm, nurturing, genuine, compassionate, sincere, caring. And he or she then brings this into the counselling room or the therapy room and is felt by the client that way. So when a person goes for counselling or goes for therapy, you might be able to have this sense of the therapist as having such qualities, and some of them will appeal to you a lot and cause you to feel safe enough to talk about your private issues or maybe to cry about something that's painful. or to share parts of you that you have not shared with any other human being out there. Like I said earlier on, the therapist also brings along his or her own characters and personality. So not every single counsellor or therapist will have the same amount of patience or spirituality or liveliness or openness about all this. And it is actually a strength not to have everyone the same. Every one of us actually seeks different things out there. Sometimes a person may see a therapist that has all these qualities yet feel unsafe, and that the person doesn't seem to connect with you. And that's okay as well, it happens. This is an issue of fit, and sometimes it happens because the therapist, in his or her looks or physical attributes or certain mannerisms or certain qualities, reminded you of someone else in the past. So when this remembering of someone from the past is good, it allows you to open up and feel safe a lot more quickly than if, let's say, the person is neutral. Conversely, the mannerisms and the attitudes or the physical attributes or the tone, the smell even, may cause you to remember a certain awful person in your past. Maybe somebody who was very critical, maybe somebody who caused you a lot of pain, maybe someone who had judged you and rejected you, or someone who has been mean to you and maybe to your friends or your family. When this happens, you will actually have a negative transference. So you will associate this therapist with those negative memories of this mean or bad person in your past, and you will not feel safe. If this is the case, then it will be good if you can actually find a different therapist to work with, because only in safety will you be able to talk more about your experience. Okay, so I've talked about the 9 different reasons why people go for therapy, as well as why people nowadays need therapy more than those in the past. I've also spoken about some of the attributes that a good therapist or counsellor has. I hope that all this has been useful to you. So thank you for watching, and see you again. Bye bye.